Welcome back to my channel. After I put out my video on minimal design, do watch it if you haven't. I received many requests to share ideas on designing small spaces. And I completely understand it because it's only a few who can enjoy the luxury of large spaces. Most people in India have smaller spaces, and yet everyone can enjoy the luxury of design and the comforts that it brings into our lives. How? By listening to me, of course. For those who are new here, I'm Monica Khosla Bhargav, founder and principal architect of Khum Consultants, an architecture and interior design firm. And now, let's get into the video. There are five areas that you need to consider when you approach the design of a small space. The aim, of course, is to create an illusion of a larger space. The first thing that you need to consider is flooring. This is very important as it creates the base of the design. Keep it plain, simple, no pattern, no inlays. Keep it as monochromatic as possible. The common mistake that I've noticed people make is to add a contrasting border or a margin on the floor. What does this do? This immediately curtails your vision to the area within the border, and it makes this place look smaller. This practice, it's borrowed from earlier times when marble or tiles, they were laid in a room in a regular or the diagonal barfi pattern. This arrangement was then defined by the margins. It worked well when the size of the room was large, but with small rooms, it's an absolute no-no. Now, I'm going to share a secret which I use to expand the floor area of a room. I add a molded skirting to the edge of the floor and the wall. And what does this do? It expands your vision to curl up and include those 4 inches of the wall as part of the floor area of the room. The second thing that I'm going to emphasize on is the importance of windows in a small space design. Space within your room is fixed. If you internalize the design, you will only be emphasizing the limited area within the walls. But if you shift your focal point to the windows and to the view outside the window, you will be able to visually expand your space. Now, if you have a great view outside your window, well then you're lucky, your picture wall is ready. But just in case, if you don't have a great view, then you need to create one, and a good way to do that is with plants. Use them on your window ledge, or if you don't have a ledge, then use those planters which can be attached to your window grills. Add some uplighters so that they can create an enchanting atmosphere even in the evenings. Don't use the fairy lights here. I know you must be thinking of those. They attract too much attention to themselves. Now, since I had mentioned grills, let me remind you to paint them black and definitely not white. The white grills, they really stand out against the night sky and create a very harsh definition of space. Another aspect, the draperies. Stick to using the Roman or the horizontal blinds and preferably within the window aperture. I would also prefer that you use it in the same tones as the wall colors so that when they're drawn, they just blend in with the walls rather than standing out like a focal point. With floors and windows done, the third thing that needs your design attention are the walls. Using a light color tone on all the walls of the room helps to expand the visual perception of space. Yes, all the walls, which means no accent wall. I know, everyone wants an accent wall, but it makes a small space really cramped up. Now, I prefer using the tonal colors and running them on the doors as well. Tones, they are colors with a hint of black in them and they create a greater depth. For a better understanding of tones and tints, do watch my video on how to create a color palette for your house. Tones are slightly duller, but they create a beautiful backdrop for the crisper colors which can be used on the furniture and accessories. Now, on the subject of walls, I've also received queries from you all on whether a mirror wall can be used to create a perception of a larger space. If your room is rectangular, which most rooms are, then place the mirror on the longer wall and not the narrower wall. This way you can create an illusion of a wider space. If you place it on the narrower wall, well then the room gets a long tunnel effect. Also, if the mirror faces a window, then it gets to reflect the light, and this helps to elevate the luxe level of the room. Now, don't ignore the ceiling in the design. This is the fourth point that I'm listing. Paint it in the same tonal color as the walls. I generally paint it one tone lighter. Now, in a room on the roof, the ceiling fan occupies the center point. And I know a wide variety of colors and designs is available in the market for fans, but for a small space, I recommend that you stick to the whites. No colors, no trims, just plain whites. A wide variety is also available in white fans, so don't be disappointed. Use architectural lights which are embedded in a false ceiling. Now, why am I saying this? I know you don't want to reduce the height of the room by adding a false ceiling. It's because ceiling lights, they light up the entire volume of the room, while wall lights, they have a limited spread and make the room look smaller. Of course, you can indulge with a suspended lamp in a corner. It's much better than using a floor lamp. It frees up the floor space and it helps the vision move upward to enjoy the volume of the space. Now, it's better to avoid the cove lighting on the roof here because it's going to cause a flicker when the fan is on, which is very disturbing. It will have that same effect of curtailing the space, similar to the border on the floor. If a cove is needed, then reverse it. Let it be around the fan. Now, the last and most important point, the furniture and accessories in the room. This is the toughest. It requires you to make all the tough decisions. I know you want that cushy sofa to sink into, a cabinet for your collection of books and mementos, a big television with a sound system, lots of storage, a lazy boy, and so on. It's not easy to fit the aspirations of an entire family into a tiny space. So I recommend that you go back and watch my video on minimal design. Create a list of the things you need in the room, not everything you want. The things without which you just cannot do. Just the bare minimum. You'll be pleasantly surprised to see how quickly your list has shrunk. Now create a layout with this bare minimum furniture requirement. Remember to choose furniture which is sleek and airy, like the mid-century sofas or beds. I'm mentioning the mid-century style just as a reference. You can get a lot of contemporary pieces which are also not bulky. Remember, the key principle here is not to get anything bulky in the room. Once you have your furniture layout ready, and this is another design secret I'm sharing, try to create a single focal point in the room. I'm repeating this, just one focal point. It could be your sofa, your rug, a painting, your TV cabinet, whatever. Everything else should move into the neutral color tones matching the walls. Discard those thoughts that I'm going to get a dark colored sofa with some bright printed curtains and a rug in some rich hues so that it's easy to maintain from the point of view of dust, dirt, and stains. There are a lot of fabrics and surface finishes available which are equally easy on maintenance. I should know, I have a dog in the house. I leave you with these five basic design concepts of planning a tiny space, flooring, no patterns, externalize the design using your windows, walls in light tones, architectural lights in the ceiling, and minimal furniture. Let me know in the comments if you need any clarifications, and if you found these tips useful, well then, you know what to do. Press the like button and subscribe to my channel. Your support means a lot to me and the design community. See you next time. Shuru kare? I'm repeating this. Light chali jayegi.